The Bible says that Jesus will come back like a thief in the night. Which means when you're not ready, when you're asleep, and quickly. Some might think, well, I'll call upon his name later. When it gets bad, then if it gets really bad, then I might do that. Well, if he returns in a twinkling of an eye, there's no time. There's no time. Just based on his true word, he says he will come back in that manner. He didn't say, oh, it'll be a slow, long, you know, train ride here. So, he's coming, and he's coming fast. And you won't be ready. All the indicators of what's going to happen. Yes, the Bible says it's going to be bad, and it's going to be people dying in mass, and it is going to be the worst since the recorded since the beginning of recorded time. It is going to be that bad, which my imagination I can't even conceptualize what's going to happen. But with all the guns in North America alone, it's not very plausible that they're coming door to door. They're going to work their way down the street. They know the opposition there would be too great. And too slow. $6.5 billion people in this world. They say too many, but you know, room for more, definitely. There's loads of room. So if they took out 1 million or 3 million, they took out a large city. That would get the ball rolling. That would still leave 6,497,000,000. So even at that rate, they hadn't made much of a dent. But it has to be fast. They can't plod along now at this point with all the infrastructure that they have set up throughout this world. I mean, this bill, that bill, and Lisbon Treaty, and the Lisbon Treaty has the death penalty stuck away in there. That's not it's not by accident that you don't pass a bill or make a law if you don't at some point plan to implement that. Let's just put it in there for a lark. That'll get people's attention. They plan on using that. So things have to get bad, and they have to get bad and quick. When it does happen, quick. Right now, they are just chipping away, taking away anybody's hope. Demoralizing you. So you're going to be absolutely just a ball of nerves and incomplete confusion. And then it's going to be big, folks. It's got to be big. They have the weapons 70 odd years ago, you know. They use those. What do they have now? They have the same and worse. Nobody saw that coming. Now, we know it's coming, but we choose not to believe it. It's like we choose not to believe Jesus. Either or, you don't believe they're going to use this or do this, you'll die. And if you don't believe in Jesus as your Lord, your Savior, your Redeemer, your strength, your fortress, your joy, your peace, your salvation, who's, you know, who died and gave his life for you, if you don't know him, you're dead as well. Lose, lose. But whatever comes, and you know him, and you profess with your tongue, and you proclaim and believe in your heart that Jesus came, died for you, shed his blood for you, everlasting life. I just find it hard to believe that everybody is yelling and fighting and pointing things out. They're fighting to stay alive, but pointing things out. Look what's going on. Look what's going to happen. And then still themselves be caught unaware. It's going to be bad, people. Be it these people who are having dreams and sharing these dreams, they all line up and they're all the same thing. There's people who've been having these for years and they all seem to be the same. There's people here, you are all here in mass sharing what is going on. Why others could give a rat's, gonna watch the Oscars and whatever, you know. Watch the hockey game and they don't care. But you guys care. You care enough to be here. So I care enough to be here too and proclaim Jesus will save you. So repent. I know people won't listen. That saddens me. That saddens God. But he says, say it anyway. Say it anyway. So, you know, that's why I started this channel. So, you know, turn to him. Seek him. Question yourself. Why are you here? Why are you here wanting to tell people? To save them. Me too. So seek him, please, while you have a chance. It'll be so quick, you won't be able to scream out God. You won't be able to scream out Jesus. Jesus, help me. In a twinkling of an eye. Get ready, folks. Please. I love you so much. Please. I want no blood on my hands. So I am here. He loves you so much. So much.